In this video, we're going to look at what's new with the Notes app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at what's new with the Notes app with iPadOS 18. Let's go over to my iPad. So I have an iPad Pro here. It's an 11-inch, and it does support Apple Intelligence. It is running iOS 18.1, actually. But what I do have, let's go ahead and open up my Settings app. You're going to see that I do have Apple Intelligence here turned off. The first few features that I'm going to show you do not require Apple Intelligence. Towards the end of the video, we'll take a look at a couple of features that do require Apple Intelligence, and I'll come back in here and turn this on. All right, with that out of the way, let's take a look at what's new. First thing we're going to look at is collapsible sections. And again, this does not require Apple Intelligence. So let's go over to my iPad here, and we're going to open up the Notes app. I tap on it. And now what we need to do is we need to create a new note. So I'm just going to go to the upper right-hand corner, tap on a new note there, and we have our new note. Now, if you're not familiar with how notes work, you probably are, but if you're not familiar, the first line that you start typing is the title. So I'm just going to type in here, this is the title. And this will come in key shortly. So I go title. And when I hit return, basically what it does is it turns it into the body text. So it's changing the style. So right now, this is title text. And when I start typing here, it's going to be body text. And again, this is going to be key with collapsible sections, you'll see shortly. So I'm just going to type in here, topic. This is going to be the topic. And we can see that it is slightly smaller. Now I'm going to go line one and line two, real creative here. I also did this on my iPhone video for this. Basically the same thing. So I go line one and line two. So now I have my lines here. What I would like to do is make the topic, the word topic, be collapsible. So then what it'll do is it'll go and hide line one and line two. It doesn't delete them, it just hides them. So how do we do that? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to change the style. Remember I talked about styles? This is a style of body. If I change it into title, heading, or subheader, it makes it collapsible. So how do we do that? Well, basically we just have to place the cursor in there. So I'm going to tap to place my cursor in topic. We can see that it is there. And now I need to go and change the style. So what we do is we just go up to the double A's here. When I tap on those double A's, you're going to see that I'm able to change the style. So we have heading and subheading. And if we go over to the right, I also have title. I can change it to any one of these. And when I do, it's going to make it collapsible. So let's go and change it to a heading here. So it's just slightly larger. I tap on it, and now we can see that topic here is slightly larger. But if we look at it closely, you're going to see that there's a little caret to the left, and it is pointing down. This means that it is open. This is the collapsible section. When I tap on that caret, let's go ahead and tap on it, it tucks those two lines up underneath it. It hides them. I tap on it again. It opens it back up. So all we have to do is just place our cursor in the line, and then we just go up to our double A's here and we change it to either a title, heading, or subheading. If you no longer want it to be collapsible, you can go back over to body and it'll remove that collapsible section. So that's how we create collapsible sections. In addition to that, we can also highlight text. Basically, we can change the color. How do we do that? Well, basically, all we have to do is just select the text. So I'm going to tap in here. We're going to go over to here to line two, and I want to highlight that. Maybe it's something that I really like, or I want to highlight it and show other people. So I select it. Now what we do is we just go up to our double A's again, and you're going to see we have a new tool there, highlight. So when I tap on the purple dot, I'm able to choose my color that I want to highlight it with. So we'll just go with purple, and now we can see that it is purple. I want to remove the highlighting. Again, I select it. It is selected. I just go up to the double A's here, and I tap on this little icon here, and it'll remove that highlighting. So now we can easily highlight our text. What else do we have? Well, In addition to that, we can now transcribe audio. So if you're at a seminar or some kind of a presentation and you want to record it, when you record it using the Notes app, you can also get a transcription. So how do we do that? Well, basically what we need to do, I'm just going to hit return here. What we need to do is we need to start recording. So let's just say that I'm at some kind of a presentation. I want to record it. So I go up to the paperclip here, and when I do, you're going to see that we have the option to record audio. When I tap on record audio, it's going to pull up a card, and I can start recording. When I start recording, I'm also going to be able to get a transcription for this. It'll transcribe it. And this does not require Apple Intelligence. As you saw earlier, I had Apple Intelligence turned off. I haven't turned it back on yet. So I'm going to hit record here. I'm going to read a short little paragraph here. Record audio sessions within your note and generate live audio transcriptions. You can search through or combine with other comments, checklists, or documents. When I'm done, I just tap on the pause here. And then all I have to do is just tap on done, and it'll save that recording. When it saves that recording, let's go ahead and tap on done here, you're also going to see that I have a transcription. When I tap on this, not only can I play it, but when I tap on this, not only can I play it, but I can also view that transcription. So it'll transcribe it on the fly. And then from here, what you're able to do is select that text, copy it, paste it into something else. And this will stay within the note. So when I tap on done here, you're going to see that it is within my note here. So that's how live audio transcription works. Now let's take a look at math notes. With math notes, what we're able to do is write out formulas. How do we do that? Well, basically, we just have to go and draw on the screen. We just draw our formula. So what I'm going to do is go up to the pen tool here. This is where we can draw. So I'm just going to draw there. And then I select my pen and I just start writing my formula. So I'm just going to go with a simple 2 plus 2. Again, what I did with my iPhone video as well. So I just type in here 2 plus 2 equals. Real simple. But when we look at this, you're going to see it says solve. So it realizes that that is a formula. And of course, you can make more complicated formulas here. So I'm going to tap on solve, and we can see that it is 4. Now it's a different color because this will change. What do I mean by that? Well, basically, what I'm able to do is tap on this 2. Maybe I didn't mean that to be a 2. I want to take that out. I want to make that a 4. Well, when I tap on it, we have this little slider here, and all I have to do is just slide this to the left and right, or right and left there. And when I do, it's going to change this number. And then you're also going to see this number here change. So I just slide it, and you can see that those are changing there. I can do the same thing with this number here. So that's how Math Notes work, and it'll store it within the Notes app there. Now let's take a look at how Apple Intelligence works with the Notes app. Basically, we have two features. We can have it refine our handwriting, which comes in handy if you have illegible handwriting, like myself. And then we can also use writing tools to help us rewrite text or even change the tone. Let's first look at how we can have it refine our handwriting. But the first thing that we need to do is we need to turn on Apple Intelligence. So I'm going to go back over to my Settings app. Swipe up. We go over here to Settings. And then I go over here to Apple Intelligence. And I need to make sure that this is turned on. When I turn this on, I'm able to use those Apple Intelligence features. So now that it is on, let's go back over to my notes. So I swipe up, and we're going to go back over to my notes. So now I need to write something out. I'm just going to write out hello. How do we do that? Well, basically, all we have to do is just go to the pen tool here, and we can draw on the screen. So I'm just going to swipe up here a little bit, and I go over here to the pen tool, and I write out what I want to write. So I'm just going to write out hello in cursive, and I'm going to make it a little bit sloppy. Not that hard for me to do. And we can see it says hello. Now, you'll notice that it refined it. So it recognized that I was writing out hello, and then it rewrote it and made it more legible. But it's still in handwriting. Let's go and do this in print. I'm not going to write it in cursive. So now I'm going to undo. I just tap on undo here. And we're going to do the same thing. And this time what I'm going to do is just write it out. So I'm just going to go, hello. A little sloppy again, but you're going to see that it recognized that and then it rewrote it. Now from here, what you're able to do is even straighten it out. It is at a slight angle here. So what you can do is you can straighten that out. To do that, what we need to do is we need to select it. And how do I select things? Well, in this case here, I go to another note again, and then I'll go back. So I'm going to tap on another note. I go back. Now I can select this. I just long press on it. And you're going to see a pop-up menu. And in this pop-up menu, when we go over to the far right, you're going to see straighten. And what it'll do is it'll straighten it out. So if it was really crooked, it'll straighten it out. So you can see now it is a little bit more straighter. That pop-up menu is also where you can manually refine. When you first set up Apple Intelligence, it'll ask you if you want to use Refine automatically. This is how I have mine set. So when I write something out, it refines it automatically. But if you didn't want it to do that, you don't have to have it auto-refine. And when you have that setting, what you need to do is you need to go to that pop-up menu. So again, I long press, and then you're going to see Refine up here, and it'll go and rewrite it for you. So you have to do it manually. I like to keep it on manual here, or automatic here. Now let's take a look at writing tools. With writing tools, we can use Apple Intelligence to help us rewrite text. Not refine it like what we just did with handwriting, but actually rewrite it. We can change the tone. We can have it proofread it for us. Let's see how we do this. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to go over to a different note where I have some text. So I'm going to go over to this note here. And when I tap on it, you're going to see that I have some text here. Now, this has a typo in here. I'm not sure if it's really clear. What I would like to do is proofread this, or maybe even make it a little bit more friendly. This is where writing tools come into play. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to select it. So I'm just going to go and select the text here. And then once it's selected in our pop-up menu, you're going to see writing tools. And if you have Apple Intelligence, when I tap on this, you're going to have a number of different options. I'm able to proofread it and rewrite it. I can also change the tone, make it more friendly, professional, or concise. And I can also insert a summary or key points or make a list or add a table. And this is all using Apple Intelligence. So let's just go ahead and make this a little bit more friendly. It's going to proofread it and it's going to make it more friendly. So I tap on friendly here. And now it is rewriting it. And once it is done, if I like what I see, all I have to do is just tap on done here and it'll accept that. If I want to go back, maybe I don't like it, I can also just go to revert. So I'm just going to tap on done. And now it is more friendly. Apple Intelligence rewrote that for me. So basically, all we have to do is just select our text and then go to writing tools. But you do need to have Apple Intelligence for this to work. So that is what is new with the Notes app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. We have collapsible sections. We can highlight text. We have live audio transcriptions. We have math notes. You can write out formulas. And if you have an iPad that supports Apple Intelligence, you can also have it refine your handwriting. And you can use writing tools to have it rewrite what you type. So that is what is new with the Notes app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, you can also check out danstutorials.com. Even though I have over 400 videos on YouTube as of this recording, I have a lot more on my site, danstutorials.com. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, the site is a membership-based site. You can view all the videos, but there are ads in them. When you become a member of my site, you no longer see the ads. I take out all the ads. You also have access to an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius. And you have access to my classes and webinars, which I hold on a regular basis. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. I'm not part of some large organization. I just sit in a spare bedroom of my house that I turned into a studio. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.